I'm not calling for an immediate withdrawal from Iraq or a reduction in funding for our troops, but I am calling for a new strategy that will move our troops out of combat operations and on the path to continuing home.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got them.
The man you just heard was Senator Pete Domenici, Republican of New Mexico, saying that he is looking for a withdrawal from Iraq. Also, Representative John Doolittle, Republican of California, calling for a withdrawal from Iraq. It's over, man. It's done.
John Doolittle almost lost Pete Domenici, in trouble to some extent. I'm not saying that their beliefs aren't also heartfelt, but
I am. They're not heartfelt at all. They're a bunch of liars. Okay, they're a bunch of cowardly liars.
Well, you know, I actually don't. I never like the thanks. I never like the cowardly part because I mean, look, they're politicians. This is what
that's what they do for a living.
Yeah, well, no, not be cowardly liars. It's not true. I mean, if you want to act like you want to say politicians are cowardly, you can do it every single day about almost every single politician. But anyway, I certainly am not going to stand here for the principled beliefs of John Doolittle and Pete Domenici. It's funny that Pete Domenici is in trouble. You know, he's a Republican icon, an institution, and it is only but his behavior to clearly write a letter to try and get David Iglesias fired because he didn't investigate in Democrats. That's obvious. And he called Iglesias to get him to kickstart an investigation of non-existent voter fraud against Democrats, that all of a sudden he's in trouble in New Mexico, which is a state that is clearly a 50-50. And John Doolittle was in a really tough re-election campaign just back in 2006.
I mean, come on, man. These two guys were among the top bootlickers for 6 years. They wore out their tongue licking Bush and Cheney's boots. And now all of a sudden, Doolittle has a little scare in an election. Oh, all of a sudden, he's for withdrawal in Iraq. Well, look at that. And Pete Domenici just got his polls back. The worst polls of his entire career in New Mexico. See, I wonder why Domenici all of a sudden had a change of heart in New Mexico. I wonder. It was probably out of a true principle, and he said he talked to the families of the soldiers, and that's what changed his mind. Liar.